we had to go digital because the manual systems cannot generate certificates. And we think that routine immunization will also generate certificates. There are people in America, they ask, can you give us the vaccination record of your child who is a colleague of mine? He's, that time he was 35, he had gone there to do PhD, they asked him for vaccination record. Where do you start? Where do you start? Our records are scattered. My acting last born was born in Mulago. You must leave all windows open. Was born in Mulago, was vaccinated with the first dose there. Because I live in Mukono, second dose in Mukono. Third dose, when they went to Mukono, there was a problem there, they went to Luzira. Mulago counts the child of the program manager and drop out. Mukono counts the child of the program manager and drop out. And so is Luzira. Why? Because our record systems are manual and they're not speaking to each other. So the quality of data we are using is low. We know it. Is low. So with low quality data, you generate low quality evidence and you make poor programming. The recommendation to get vaccines is after 1 month, after 1 month, after 1 month. But there are people who are doing this after 3 months, after 2 months, after 3 months. What does that mean for immunogenicity? So I just want to emphasize that the path for digitization, for the path for digitization of immunization data is a journey we have started and we are moving forward. The only areas of difference would be what is the appropriate technology you need to use to have a nationwide rollout of the vaccination program so that you capture. Otherwise, immunization is the only program with the deepest penetration to communities. And we do not want internet availability, network, computer, and skills at this moment to limit the use, to limit vaccination activity because you are not computer savvy. So what we are working on are appropriate technologies which can allow us to digitize data captured using other options. And it's not the subject of today, and this is the journey we have already started. But at the end of the day, you should be able to generate an electronic database which allows manipulation, allows analysis at the higher levels. So this campaign which we are going to do, first of all, we are going to have the registration of every person vaccinated. We're expecting about 13 or 15 million, I'm not sure, Biroma. What's our target? 15 million or 13 million?
14 million.
14 million people are going to be vaccinated in January in 5 days. And when, by the way, I think Ugandans don't stop to admire the capacity they have. The capacity we have for doing public health response is very phenomenal. So containment of these diseases here, I don't think it comes by accident. It doesn't. So for us, we will vaccinate that number. I'll also come and tell you this is the number we've vaccinated. So what we will do is there is what we call smart paper technology. We'll use it for capturing the data with the hand. But there are scanners with artificial intelligence which can transform this into digital information. Then that register can now give us the statistics we need. And so we scan, And that means the individual data access on SHIFO platform, this is the platform which we are currently using. So the data captured will be aggregated, and the data systems can be accessed, and it will generate for us the yellow fever certificate, which is an electronic version. So the yellow fever card, the tally sheets, and this, we will use them for monitoring the campaigns. You see, if you're in Kampala, you need to know all districts are doing it. You may find that the district is silent, but you have committed money there, you have sent supervisors there. So for you to intervene immediately, you need a dashboard that guides you to monitor. So that is it. Now, the point of convergence is here. Right now, AELHU has developed a system where people enter their data into the computer, isn't it?
Yes.
So you enter the information into the computer, and through the link, you can be able to verify that this person was vaccinated from this point, and so on, and so on.
Right.
So what we are saying is, this process we are going to use will have this database. And this database should be able to speak to the database you're already generating for the travelers. Then through the link, you should be able to verify whether someone was vaccinated through here or through the system which you have. So in terms of principle, this is the direction. But the technology gurus will be the one now to work the details. But for us, what we believe in is, yes, the main systems will be in use in this country, but the most important thing is they must be interoperable. This is the key message. So you can move to the next. I think I've already said what is the next slide. Yes, so the information sitting on the APVAC, that's the system which I was describing, and the system used by AELHU should become interoperable and to produce yellow fever certificates, and also to be. So, for me, this is where we are, and it sits, this presentation sits on the fact that, number one, we need to appreciate where yellow fever vaccination sits in international health regulation. Number two, we need to protect the integrity of the health certificates we issue, and the private sector, in the absence of a strong regulatory framework, organize themselves into a group to take charge of that area. And appropriate MOUs have been signed to that effect. So you continue doing it on behalf of GABU, Ministry of Health. Now, we are also having the major program of vaccinating all the adult population, and we are creating a database so that if my grandmother is at home, is not traveling, maybe he doesn't want the digital system. I don't know. But when he wants to visit me, when I become Uganda's ambassador to Tanzania, then it is at that point that the issue of verification becomes handy. So that is also an area. How does it happen? Because government services are provided free, and other people who are vaccinated through the regular program, how do they get the certificates we issue for travel? We need to be clear on that, because this is going to be another phase of the challenges we will face from February, not very far. Someone said, no, I was already vaccinated in Ibundibujo. My card is here, but it will not be accessed by. How do we move about it? So because these are public issues, the answers don't come quickly. It requires deep thought, it requires stakeholder engagement, and it requires decisions which we take that fit in the overall framework of doing business in the country. So thank you very much. there's no question in this room whether we go digital or not. That question shouldn't be in this room. The question is that we are already digital. Let us see where the gaps are, how can we improve, and then we move on. Thank you very much, Doctor. Any issues, any concerns, any questions? Is there anything you wanted to say before? Yes, please. I'm going to give you only two, three people, and then I'll call upon the next GR session.